What's happening, people? Welcome back to the channel. This is Fight Talk to the BMAs, Basic MMA Analyst. I am here alone just because of timetables and whatnot. I was not able to get Slick on the call today. My Sunday just became very busy and whatnot. So I'm just doing a solo one, a real quick one. There wasn't many fights this week. There was the boxing, which we'll get to in a second. I mean, I don't follow boxing too much, but I saw some highlights. We'll get to that in a second. But the next UFC fight card that's coming up will be on June 5th, so next Sunday, next week, and that's between Alexandra Volkov versus Jairzinho Rozenstruik. Both coming off a loss, number 7 against number 8. I guess this is going to be a fight between, it's a good fight to make because they're both coming off a loss, to see who can kind of progress up in within the ranks. So, I mean, the card itself is, you know what? They just put this card out. I feel like they just put it out. I've been searching for this card for the last couple of weeks to talk about it. We're supposed to talk about it last week. But it wasn't even up until now. And I see a lot of the card on the UFC site, a lot of the pictures are blanked out. So I don't know if they're new fighters or whatnot. But anyway, you got Dan Ige on the card versus Mozart Eliov. I don't know, my bad. Felicia Herring versus Carolina I can't pronounce her surname, but she once fought for the title once. And then you've got the prelims. So, something to keep us entertained until the week after, because that's when the big one is in Singapore. June 12th in Singapore. That's the big one. Hopefully me and Slick can talk about it next week. I will be in London, but by the time we do the podcast or the video talk, whatever, I'll be in Singapore still, almost catching a flight to London. Anyway, we'll talk about that. But yeah, I mean, next week, we haven't had no fights this weekend. UFC kind of spoils us and give us fights every week. So it'd be great to get another little fight night going on next week. With the boxing, like I said, I'm not a boxing, I don't follow boxing much at all, but Gervonta Davis versus Rollo Romero, I saw some highlights. I saw Davis knock him out it looked like a slip and a left hook, if I remember correctly. I think that was in round 6. But I won't comment on it too much because I don't know much about boxing and I did not watch the fight. Other than that, I mean, other MMA news that I saw, Nick Diaz is saying he wants to come back this year and he wants a title shot against Kamaru. Now, maybe because of his popularity, they'll give it to him. I'm sure Kamaru will want that, so you know, he gets all pay-per-view numbers and everything, so I don't see a reason why he would say no. It just don't make sense, right? Just because Nick's been out for so long. He had that fight against Robbie Lawler and it didn't go his way, and he looked good though. I mean, he was throwing punches left, right, and center and just stopped at one point, but maybe, like he said, there was loads of shit going on. He didn't even want that fight. But look, due to popularity, maybe he'll get it. Maybe. But there is, I mean, I'm sure it just pissed off a lot of people, but the casuals will probably love it just because it's Nick Diaz. Kamaru just get a fresh face. It'll be an interesting fight. It'll be interesting. There was some other news. What other news is there? I saw Paddy Pimblett. He's fighting in London. Let me just double check it. Against my guy. What's his name? The dude who does the splits when he celebrates and he starts twerking and whatnot. It's funny. Where is it? Paddy Pimblett, here we go. There's Paddy. Fight Jordan Levite at UFC London anyway. So they're coming back to London. The last London card was amazing. So look at it, they're looking to get the same hype. I think it was finishing, there was a finish in every freaking fight, which was awesome. Let's see how, because Jordan is you know, he's no easy task for Paddy, and Paddy's building up, and I think Paddy's being smart. He's not trying to jump the line or whatnot. He's trying to get up there slowly. So that's you see how that goes with Paddy. He does get hit, and he does say he needs to get hit to kind of get going. But maybe one day that hit will be the last hit, right? If it hits the button, then you're done, right? So let's hope anyway he learns from that. And he's able to avoid those hits and get up there. But that should be interesting. And if Jordan wins, I'm sure we'll see another fun, expressive victory dance or whatever he wants to do, man, be it twerking or whatnot. But yeah, no, that should be interesting. Other news, what else has been going on? I can't even see anything. Yeah, I think that's it, you know. It's a small one. We'll keep it short this week. Next week, I'll probably have Curtis back on. We'll talk more MMA news. At least we'll have fights to talk about. And we can recap on the card, the Singapore card that's coming up next, the week after, which is a big one. Two title fights. I'm looking forward to that one. But anyway, on that note, just wanted to give you a little something, I guess, a little thoughts on our on the channel, right? So until then, we'll catch you on the next one. Peace.